So the idea of Pharos is to use non-visual sensing technologies to improve the autonomy of surgical spine robots.
To create smarter solutions for robotic assistance to surgeons.
A robot that hears and feels in the same way as the surgeon to make the same decision.
The biggest challenge in robotic surgery at the moment is that it might work well for very standardized steps, but since every patient is different, the adaptation of robotic processes to individual situations is not as easy as you might think.
With Pharos, we would like to improve the intraoperative decision making capabilities, making surgical robots more effective.
At Balgris University Hospital, our philosophy is that basically the relevant research questions arise during encounters with patients and their problems. Pharos did contribute to this specific challenge by using different approaches of how the robot basically understands in a clinical or a surgical situation.
The ORX plays a pivotal role in projects like Pharos. With the ORX, the researcher have the possibility to stay for more than 1 week in the ORX.
Thanks to these facilities, ORX is able to, in fact, host such a big group for such a long time.
In order to perform the final validation in a very careful and successful way. The Pharos project consists of a consortium.
It is very important to have actually a medical partner already from the beginning to effectively bring together, to integrate the different technologies from the different partners. What we in fact want to do is we want to develop systems that are also actually used afterwards.
And these complementary experiences make the Pharos project so successful. The biggest challenge during the Pharos project was the integration of the different components. The groups came together in so-called integration weeks to make out of these components a working robotic system. And this was extremely challenging, but also exciting.
The Pharos project was certainly a success, not only defined by the scientific results, but also by bringing together so many experts from different fields and even different countries.
There was zero before, and we ended up with a system that was validated on ex vivo human specimen and also in vivo animal experiments. We achieved a good accuracy already. We are not in a range that is clinically acceptable, but the accuracy is very promising.